Are you serious? Are you serious? Folks, we have a terrible landslide in China, and they're still pulling the bodies out from tons and tons of earth. The number of bodies recovered from the landslide that's engulfed the workers at a Chinese construction site has now risen to 31 bodies have been found, 7 people still missing, according to authorities. The heavy rains over the weekend buried a temporary shed under 100,000 cubic meters of mud rock used by workers as a hydropower station construction site in China. Major rescue efforts were continuing, but to no avail. The number of victims, which has fluctuated between different medias, but it's been revised now. We're down to 31 people are dead, 7 still missing. Deadly landslides are common in China. At least 58 people were killed by a landslide in southern commercial hub back in December, where there was some work being done. And 25 of people are still unaccounted for in that landslide. So it's a common situation. It takes place there. It's not a good one at all. And we pray for the families of these that have died in this horrific, tragic situation. We know in Afghanistan, we had another terrible situation where a bus full of passengers crashed head-on into an oil tanker, killing 73 people and wounding over 50 in a horrible, horrible scene in Afghanistan. And this has happened before, oil tankers crashing into passenger buses. And I immediately have to start asking, could there have been any suicidal terrorist activity here from some radical jihadists? It could be an accident, but this has happened before. And so you have to always ask yourself the question, what's going on here? And of course, the wildfires are still burning out of control in Canada. They're unbelievable. And the question's being raised now by BP Earthwatch. And is there any connection there with the uranium that's being transferred to Russia that was purchased in those very same companies that are not only pumping oil and fracking for gas, but uranium? And so is there any connection there? Because it's really both places that the fire is. Uranium is unbelievably high-grade uranium there that they're extracting from the earth. And the Russians are purchasing that from the Canadians. And so you start to wonder, how is there any connection there? Or is the magma that Dutch Sense is bringing up, could the all the fracking allowed the crust to be smaller and literally magma getting up through and little fissures starting to shoot little embers of lava, causing these unbelievable wildfires? Because in both of these places where the fires are is where the oil and gas and the fracking, some of the largest there is in all of Canada, is going on. Two different communities, 300 some miles apart, two massive fires. One was where 100,000 people have been evacuated. The other one, less population, so it wasn't the biggest story. But the fire is actually bigger. And in both places, fracking's going on. So is magma starting to... And because Canada is so dry, Canada dry, and I'm not, no pun intended there, but because it's like a tinderbox, that's a question being raised. It's being raised now. So I'm trying to keep you up to speed with everything going on as it relates to some of this apocalyptic weather conditions and patterns taking place. Certainly, we're living in the last days. I'll be back with more current world events and how they relate to Bible prophecy. And don't miss today's live broadcast at my website at www.paulbagleyprophecy.com. And yes, we did get live stream repaired. I'll be back.